My private cabana, luscious lips, sand of a beach, my teeny bikini, bikini so teeny, which I have on my hands, just three of the over 600 Essie nail polishes. And last night I had a chance to catch up with founder Essie Weingarten at her first ever flagship nail salon right here in New York City.
All the single ladies, all the single ladies, all the single ladies, now put your hands up.
Here I am, 65th Street in Madison, and guess who's here? Essie, the great, the wonderful nail lady. You know the colors you all get? And this is your first
flagship salon. Thanks for joining us at the opening. I am so excited.
Well, let's go inside because I want to look around, okay? Let's go. Come on, go.
Come on back to Essie Land. All us girls have a lot of fun every week. It's our me-ism time. So manis and petties and blowouts, and we can spend hours or we can be in an hour and a half.
Let's go.
So this is your spot.
This is it. This is our hideaway. This is a woman's treat. It's like candy for an adult. Here's the wool of color. What more could any woman want?
How many colors are here?
There's almost 600. There's something for everyone.
Do you have a favorite?
I love them all. They're my babies.
I don't care. I love it.
You, Essie, the great nail polish queen, has her nails done by the same person every week.
Every single
week. You don't do your own.
No, I don't. This is my me-ism time, and I love it. So there's no reason for me to do it myself. To me, it's better than any doctor. It's better than any psychiatrist. You come to the salon and you just chill out.
What should I have on my nails that need to be done badly?
I think you're going to be bikini so teeny. It will be absolutely amazing on you.
I can't wait.
Josephine Allen, the hottest manicurist in New York, is all yours, Jane. Once you have a manicure, you'll never go anywhere else.
Look at me, everybody. Are they beautiful or what? Thank you so much. Great.
Thanks for
being one of the first
at our new Essie flagship.
Thank you.
You gotta come back.
Oh, I will. Trust me. I will.
That's what makes you beautiful.
How awful is that? You go out to shoot a piece and you get your nails done.
Terrible.
The great Essie Weingarten is joining us now. Thank you. You have brought, I mean, we were just talking about this as Jackie's been doing her nails sitting
it was,
here.
It was I didn't do my nails. She's here. Camera.
Love it.
And she tells me if I put a white coat on first, it'll make it pop.
Yep.
It becomes real neon.
That's what they did to me last night. But the thing is, we were all talking about this, that when you get your nails done, you just frankly feel better.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Should you put white underneath every?
No, only on the neons. Okay. It makes it really pop. So don't worry about that. You use a base coat on every polish. Okay.
So when you started this three decades ago, what was it that you thought was going to make a difference? Because, I mean, there were nail polishes out there already. That was going on.
Absolutely. But there were beauty polishes. There was no such thing as a nail salon, and the colors were very limited. Mm-hmm. And I just couldn't find colors. If I was a good girl, my mother would take me to the beauty parlor. So I just knew that they needed some excitement and color, and I went to work with a chemist that listened to me and came out with a formula that would go on like silk, wear like iron, so my nails would always look wet.
Yeah.
And then I gave him ribbons and pin cushions, and he matched all the colors, and
I
started with 12 colors. Can you believe it?
No, it's over 600 now.
Yeah.
So I started in Vegas because they had more disposable income there. So listen, I want to talk about some of these great stories. The Queen of England, you got a letter from them saying
Her Majesty's hairdresser sent us a letter that the Queen of England wanted Essie ballet slippers. Would we be willing to sell it to him? And I picked up the phone and said, tell her I will hand deliver it. You don't have to worry about it.
So open up the palace gate.
Absolutely, I'm ready.
And Kate Middleton wore your polish on her wedding day.
She wore Allure to her wedding. And I mean, I think she's the ultimate young, sophisticated woman. Mm-hmm. She can do High Street or Main Street. She's always so chic.
Yeah.
And when she wore Allure, it was like sealing the deal. I really felt that I arrived.
Yeah. You're pretty much royalty now.
Oh,
the Queen and Kate.
And we even had American royalty
Dylan Lauren. That's as close as we get.
She wore it on her wedding day.
Yeah,
and Lady Gaga.
Oh, my God. When she was at the MTVs wearing the steak on her head, she wore Merino Cool on her nails, which is this right here.
So if you're going out for steak...
And
this is the color that you need if you're going out for dinner.
Or if
have
you're
going to
wear
steak.
One.
Absolutely.
I hope you're going to eat it, not wear it.
Yeah, I would much rather eat it.
I would too.
So the nail colors are so great. How do you come up with the names?
We have so much fun with it. Sometimes I have the names before I have the colors, and I just need a theme. All six colors have to relate to a theme.
Right.
Summer.
This
so
is
we,
summer right here, right?
Yeah, so we have Bikini Sotini because all of us, if we're not wearing it, we want to talk about it,
right.
Which is
so,
this amazing blue.
What do you think it says about Sarah that this is the one she really likes?
I love the all tied up.
Of course.
Tell me about me.
That sounds very provocative. What about Mojito Madness?
I like that
amazing.
Too.
Which one's that one?
The green.
One.
Doesn't it look like your mojito?
Oh, that's nice.
I like this green, too.
We have Farrah Desire. Which is so pretty, the orange.
Oh, the orange.
Yes, Farrah Desire.
I love the colors.
So you pick a theme, and then how do you come up with the color? Like, what's the process? What do you guys go through?
Well, the process here was, what were we going to do for the advertising? Mm. And that was a great sign that went into the sand, so it had different directions for different beaches. So from there, we went, okay, Bikini Sotini, all tied up, all different types of bathing suits,
mm-hmm.
off the shoulder.
Mm-hmm.
Mojito Madness is what you're drinking when you're at the beach.
Absolutely.
And, you know,
absolutely.
So it all
so are there any rules about what color you're going to wear?
There's no rules. All rules have been broken. If the color fits, wear it. You know, if you can wear it from the bedroom to the boardroom to the ballroom and always be perfect.
But what are you supposed to wear with a red dress?
Mm-hmm. Well, okay, you can do a sophisticated sheer color, any of these like ballet slippers, Mademoiselle, Vanity Fairest, which is always right.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can wear a fantastic red.
You can wear red.
You can wear red. And you can also do something like Wicked, which is a black red, which is my favorite.
But can you do dark colors in the warmer months and loud colors like this that are typically for warm months in the cold months?
Absolutely.
Yes?
If the color fits, if it makes you feel good, you wear it.
I love it. And from Essie. So when you see me with my dark polish this summer, it's
okay. From the queen.
Absolutely.
So the first ever Essie flagship nail salon is at 35 East 65th Street.
Right, between Madison and Park. I mean, what better location could you possibly want?
It's so great.
And everyone there is amazing. So you'll get a real Essie manicure.
Fantastic. Well, the color. Colors are great. We really appreciate it.
Thank you. It's a pleasure, girls.
Thank you.
Name one after us.
Yeah. I think I will.
Okay.
You better name it after Amy first, because you'll never hear the end of it. Coming up right here and say thank you in 60 seconds.